Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Newstos, where I give you all the latest gaming news, and it's the beginning of February, which means new Xbox Game Pass games. Yeah, Xbox has officially revealed the lineup for the first half of February, and it's a pretty good lineup of games. There's a few strong games on this list that I think fans will really like, and also a couple hidden gems that you should definitely check out as well. So stick around, and we'll go over all of that later in the video, and Electronic Arts dropped a lot of new information about the upcoming Mass Effect Legendary Collection, and I have to say, it looks much better than what I thought it was going to. My hype levels are back, and I think a lot of you are going to feel that way. And for all of you Switch fans out there, I might have some good news regarding all that as well, so stay tuned for that. It's been another really busy day for gaming though. There's a lot of news to go over, so let's get right into it, starting off with another remaster. Sega has now officially unveiled a remaster for the Yakuza spin-off, Judgment, releasing on April 23rd for the PS5, Xbox Series, and Google Stadia. Now that's actually big for a few different reasons, though there are a couple downsides as well. Unfortunately, it will not be a free upgrade for those who already own Judgment on the PS4. Judgment, of course, released back in 2019 for the PS4, and it was met with praise from both critics and fans alike. So yeah, it sadly will not have a free upgrade, and that is a bit disappointing. However, as you'd expect, it's another great Yakuza experience, and seriously, if you haven't played these games already, or this one in specific, do yourself a favor and check them out. I cannot say enough good about these games if you like story-driven experiences. They clearly have perfected their craft, as it's evident that they can make good games outside of Kiryu's storyline. Like a Dragon is another great example of that, and now more fans can play Judgment. And yeah, that was a big part of this announcement. It will be getting a remaster for both the PS5 and the Xbox Series. I mean, if you think about it, Yakuza has really been a PlayStation exclusive franchise until very recent. Just 1 year ago, Xbox had no Yakuza games, and now it will have 9 Yakuza games. That's a lot of great games to get in 1 year, and from what I've been hearing, Xbox fans are absolutely loving the Yakuza games, and it's easy to see why. These really are amazing games. The other thing that might have caught your attention though, was that Judgment is also coming to Google Stadia, and Steam was not listed. This apparently is some kind of exclusive deal on PC for Stadia. Unfortunately, it will not be available on Steam on April 23rd. I imagine this is some kind of timed exclusive, and I'm not really a big fan of that type of stuff. I also know fans are not exactly happy with Google Stadia right now. As we talked about yesterday, Google just shut down their internal Stadia studios, which will make fans even more hesitant on investing into Stadia. Honestly, I just recommend waiting it out. I do imagine this is some kind of timed exclusive, and it'll probably eventually come to Steam. I'd be surprised if it doesn't, and there's already some evidence that Sega did originally reference a Steam version over on the Judgment website. I'll leave a link to that information below, but either way, I'm glad to see Judgment get a remaster and come to new platforms as well. Now, Yakuza may not exactly be getting a free upgrade for the PS5, but however, a big game will be getting a free upgrade today. Yeah, God of War is getting a free upgrade for the PS5, and it's getting that Ghost of Tsushima treatment. Essentially, what happened with Ghost was that they combined the performance mode with graphics mode that you could previously choose between on the PS4 Pro version, and it just feels fantastic on the PS5. I actually think that there might be a real debate that Ghost of Tsushima is one of the best looking games on the PS5 right now, and that's crazy to think about considering it was built for the PS4. Sucker Punch did a phenomenal job with that, and now God of War will be getting the same treatment. You will now be able to play God of War at 60 frames per second and 4K resolution. I've said this a few times, but God of War is a perfect single player experience in my opinion. I do understand that everybody has different opinions, but for me, the combat feels awesome, the visuals look great, and then the story is just absolutely amazing. That surprised me honestly, considering I didn't really care for the original trilogy and its story, but yeah, with this new update, it's gonna be one step closer to being that perfect single player experience. I really love that so many of these games are getting upgrades this generation. It will help them age much better, and the fact that they're free is greatly appreciated. Moving on, we got some news on a brand new studio. This isn't coming from a big publisher though, but rather this is coming from Quantic Dream, the developer behind hit titles such as Heavy Rain and Detroit Become Human. This is actually really interesting. I know there has been some controversy surrounding Quantic Dream, but I do think this is a talented studio. Heavy Rain is probably their most beloved game that released for the PS3, but I actually really enjoyed Detroit Become Human. It's certainly a very pretty game, but overall they do a good job with these AAA graphic adventure games. Now though, they're expanding and opening a new studio in Montreal, Canada, and from the sounds of it, they're hiring some very talented developers. The studio head is actually the former Deus Ex boss, so whatever they're working on, you might want to pay attention to. I'll be interested to see what both of their studios is doing, and as always, I'll keep you up to date on all of that as we find out more. Let's talk about those Xbox Game Pass games, though. It seems like every single month, Xbox reveals more good games for Xbox Game Pass, and really, February is no different. Now, this is just the first half of the February lineup, and I will let you know about the second half as soon as we get those details, but they did reveal a pretty solid lineup for the first half of February, so let's check it out. You have Wolfenstein Youngblood, Jurassic World Evolution, Stealth 2, Project Winter, The Falconeer, Final Fantasy XII, and Ghost of a Tell. That's a pretty good lineup of games, and this is something I do like about Xbox Game Pass. I think some of these games will really surprise fans that may have missed playing these games when they originally released. The big one is definitely Final Fantasy XII, and that is a fantastic JRPG. I definitely recommend that one. You know, Final Fantasy is often praised as being this all-time great JRPG franchise, and it truly is. And because you can play these games without playing any of the others in the franchise, 12 would be a great starting spot if you're interested in trying Final Fantasy for the first time. I think it's aged rather well being a remaster. It was originally a PlayStation 2 game, but I think it holds up well. Also, you have games like Stealth 2 and Ghost of a Tell, which are some really good hidden gems. Ghost of a Tell is especially good. That game has a lot of heart for a smaller independent game. It's got a lot of stealth-based elements in it, and it's got a strong story as well. It, however, will only be on PC, but if you have Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, I do recommend that game. Then you have The Falconeer, that was a launch title for the Xbox Series. I haven't played that myself, but after only a few short months, it's coming to Xbox Game Pass. And Project Winter will be an interesting release. So Project Winter is a day one launch title for Xbox. However, it has been available on PC since 2019, and the fan reaction for this game has been notable. Over on Steam, 86% of all reviews have been positive, but what makes this game suddenly stand out is its similarities to the breakout hit Among Us. This is a multiplayer game for 8 players that focuses on social deception and survival. Yeah, that probably sounds just a bit familiar. A lot of people are saying that Project Winter is very similar to Among Us, and maybe even better. So if you like Among Us but want something just a little different, you can go check out Project Winter. Overall though, I think there's some interesting games here to check out. There isn't that big AAA game in the first half of the month, but it seems like they usually have a big release in the second half, so in the meantime, you got plenty of interesting games to check out. Here's something interesting though, EA revealed a ton of new information on the upcoming Mass Effect Legendary Edition. We've known about this game for quite a while, but I have to say, I was a bit surprised today, and that's because it seems like BioWare and EA are putting a lot more effort into this remastered collection than what I thought they were going to. You get more than 40 pieces of single-player DLC with this Legendary Edition, and there are some significant upgrades with this collection, including reduced load times, HDR, 4K resolution, and 60 frames per second. They did finally reveal the release date as well, which will be May 14th for the Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC. It'll also be backwards compatible for the Xbox Series and PlayStation 5, where they can take advantage of 60 frames per second, HDR, and 4K resolution alongside the One X and PlayStation 4 Pro. It's still a few months away, but not too bad, and the overall performance seems to be pretty solid. The big change, though, is with Mass Effect 1 in particular. This is more in line with a remake than a simple remaster, and quite honestly, Mass Effect 1 majorly needed this. It didn't age quite as well as Mass Effect 2 or 3, but they made some drastic improvements. The character models, the environments, and just the overall visuals look so much better in this remaster. They also tweaked the gameplay in certain areas, such as the vehicle that you drive around. They improved the driving experience, which was not good in the original. So yeah, they apparently made some sweeping changes with the first game in specific, which is not only good news for Mass Effect fans, but also newcomers. This is one of the best trilogies in video games ever made, and now that they've made some improvements with the first game, a lot of these newcomers can have a better overall experience. I think if they didn't improve Mass Effect 1, a lot of newcomers would have probably quit on the first game, but thankfully they did improve the first game. They also made some other improvements such as tweaking boss fights, the character creator tool apparently got a big upgrade, and other such things. These are all very welcome additions, and for you hardcore Mass Effect fans, you can actually pick up a collector's edition over on BioWare's Gear website, where they are selling a bunch of collectibles including a helmet and a special edition case for $150. Unfortunately, this does not include the game, but there are a lot of things to like in this collector's edition. Now, I know there's still that looming question on whether or not a Switch version is in development as well. These are older games and they should run on the Switch, but you know, EA does EA things. I don't know why they consistently ignore the Switch, but I do have some good news here, or at least I'll give you some hope. While they didn't exactly confirm a Switch version, they did leave the door open for a Switch port later down the road. In an interview with Eurogamer, BioWare's Mac Walters did note that the Legendary Edition was built in mind with the Xbox One and PS4, but they would love to bring it to the Switch. Mac Walters went on to say that they had a set path for what platforms to launch on, but after that, they'll sort of see where they're at. So at the very least, it does sound like that they're considering a Switch release, but they had to get the Xbox One and PS4 version finished up first. I think this statement kind of adds up. They stuck with the Xbox One and PS4 release, even though the Xbox Series and PS5 released not long ago. So it does stack up, and I'm going to cross my fingers it does eventually come to the Switch. I think it would be a great trilogy to play on the Switch. On to the poll of the day though. With scalpers using bots to buy up all the stock for new consoles, I wanted to ask you if you thought the government should step in to stop scalpers from using bots on products such as the PS5 and Xbox Series. This has been an ongoing issue, and it's left fans frustrated since the launch of these new consoles. Well, 68% of you said that yes, it's a cheap tactic and the government should step in. I have to say though, there was some pretty strong opinions on this topic in the comments. I think for me personally, I'm really against these scalpers using bots to double the price. If a person buys two consoles or something like that without using bots, and then they want to go resell them, I have no problem with that. However, I do have an issue with bots being used, especially whenever scalpers are trying to buy hundreds of these products. As mentioned in the comments though, this isn't just a problem with consoles and video cards. It's also an issue with things like sneakers. For me though, I just don't think scalpers should be able to use bots for anything when they're selling them for absurd prices. I just don't think you should be able to do that, and fans should be able to enjoy the things that they love without paying for something that is extremely marked up because one person decided to buy up all the stock. I would like to see retailers do more to stop problems like this, and to be fair, some have been trying, but I really hope that this situation starts to get better soon. Anyways though, that's it for this episode, but if you liked the video, don't forget the bell notification and subscribe button for more content just like this. Also, if you'd like to support the channel through Patreon, thank you for making this content possible. Peace out.